Our team was in Dallas, Texas for SOLIDWORKS World 2019. This was a great event. If you weren't able to make it out, I highly recommend making the trip next year. There were over 6,000 in attendance to sharpen their SOLIDWORKS skills and learn about new technologies in manufacturing. We had the opportunity to be part of the SOLIDWORKS shop floor with our 1100 M Plus mill and our 15L slant-pro lathe on site working through 4 different parts and 9 operations. In addition to our machines, there was a 5-axis mill and a large CNC lathe and all the needed inspection equipment to ensure that the parts all met their specifications. We all worked together to make the components for a serpentine drive belt kit on a small block engine. We were tasked with making 2 power steering brackets, a tensioner bracket, and the water pump pulley. With the quick change pallet system we built for the show, it was really a great way to demonstrate how our machines can help you with your quick prototyping needs.
On the Tormach mill here, we're actually running several different parts, and what's cool about it is we're using quick change tooling and fixtures, so we can machine multiple different parts for that system. What's neat about it is they're using quick fixturing here, so on the Mighty Bites we can actually hold the stock, and then when we go to flip it over and machine the other side, we're using these compression bins to hold the part successfully. What this does is it allows you to make multiple parts really quick and easy, but be able to switch out the programs to maintain productivity. One of the cool things about these two machines that you see so far is we're actually controlling them through IQMS. So if we look up here on the back of this Matsura, you can see the antenna that's actually collecting the data wirelessly to the terminal. All of these machines are using the IQMS workflow process schedule, so they have the ability to track and understand how fast we're making parts. The runtime on the Matsura is about 3 hours. These are significantly faster because they're a smaller part, and because we can swap these out, we can make multiple parts really quick and easy. On this lathe here, we're actually making this front pulley. We're making the 2 setups or ops, then we come back and drill the holes over on that machine. You may have saw that picture. So we start by machining the part like this, and we machine in the profile, and then we flip it around in a fixture, and then we machine the outside. What's nice about this machine, just like the Tormach mill, is I have the ability to quickly change the chuck, so I can machine both sides quickly. So if you look at this here, here's the chuck with the fixture. You can pop the part on after operation 1's been done, and we can machine this outside face. So it works really well. It's really fast. Again, this is connected to IQMS, so we have the ability to pull data as the parts are completed off the machine.
But then we need to put holes in this, so we bring it over here. So we've got a piece of pallet in there, we're swapping out. So we're just machining out each part, switch everything up.
And goes up to the door.
Yeah, so the head goes up, and this actually comes over.
And it comes over.
Yep.
And he's so sweet.
Very good. So they can be machined and start to finish. This one also runs a button similar to the one over there.
I can pose for you.
Oh yeah, do it. Go for it.
I have laser.
Check out all of our latest videos here, and for more metalworking tips, tricks, and stories, subscribe to the YouTube channel.